Hi, I'm George Pearson, and these are just a few examples from some of the training videos I have here on YouTube. Now, when you're working with the training, following along the training, if you want to get the materials I used in the training, just go to the description down below and click on the link that's at the top of the description, and this will take you to a page where you can download the materials. Please subscribe, click the like button, and of course, always share on Facebook, Twitter, or wherever. I really appreciate that. Okay, let's go ahead and get started with the video. In this Photoshop Elements text project, we're actually going to be focusing on this background stuff over here. The text is pretty straightforward, not a whole lot in there, but doing these light streaks, this is the fun, interesting part. Actually, it's very, very easy to do with custom brushes. So let's go ahead and see how this whole thing is created. Let's just get this out of the way. We're going to start with a new file. File new, blank file. And I'll have this set at the default Photoshop Elements size, which is 6x4 at 300 dpi. There we go. Now I want the background to be black. So let's just fill the background with black. I'll just reverse those colors. Hit the paint bucket, and there we go. Now everything we're going to be doing is going to be on new layers. So I'll start off with one new layer here. We'll be doing several layers. We have some control. Now the whole trick to this look is to use specialty brushes. I mean, you can do it by hand if you want to, but it will take you forever. Specialty brushes get around that problem. The link for this brush set is in the description and also on the download page. Okay, let's go to our brush here, and I'll just move this over. Now the easy way to use brushes is to, instead of installing the brushes permanently inside of Photoshop Elements, it's better just to load the brushes as you need them. So set up a folder, any place you want to on your hard drive, put all of your aftermarket brushes in that folder, and then just load them as you need them. It's easy to do. Just bring up the brush dialog box here, click on that little icon, come down to load brushes. Now here's my brushes, and the one I want up here is called Abstract Brushes Volume 6. I'll click on that, and that simply loads that brush set right into my brushes right there. There's that brush set loaded in. Now when I close down Photoshop, this will go away and it won't be loaded again, so I'm not going to be cluttering up my Photoshop Elements program with a lot of brushes that I don't normally use. But I can load them each individual time. So it's the easy way to do it. Just put them into a new folder and click on load brushes every time you want to use those particular brushes. Now I'll start off with this one. I want to have my, I'll just double click on that, there we go, foreground color set to white. We're doing everything here in black and white. Now if I just come in here and click, there's that brush right there. And I'll leave that one on its own layer. There we go. Let's make a new layer in here and do that. New layer. Let's readjust the size a bit. I'll make it a lot bigger. There's another one right there, a lot larger. And let's make another layer here, and I'll make this one even bigger. Okay, this just gives me three choices of these brushes. Now let's go over here to the move tool. I can then grab this brush and move it around. Notice how it cuts it off at the bottom line where you painted that on. So just keep that in mind. And let me hide these other two for just a minute. So here we go. So I have my first brush. You can then adjust the size in here and adjust the angle. All of your normal tools will work because, of course, this is just a painted layer really at this point. That's all Elements thinks of this as. So I'll put that one kind of like that. Let's bring up our next layer, which is right here. I'm going to lock this layer. There we are. That will just won't give me any problems that way. Bring this one in here. Just kind of overlap this a bit. Maybe rotate a little bit more that way. A little size change. If you want to get real fancy, you can actually reverse these. Let me just show you that on this next layer down here. I'm going to lock this layer as well. Come down to this layer, show that one. And that's this little guy here. Let's say I wanted this going the other direction. Simply grab the side and pull it like that, and you can reverse the direction. There we go. And I'll bring that up a bit, rotate that, and I'll just drop that over in here. So I'm just making something kind of complex right down in there. You know, whatever you do, it can be like this, it can be different. It's really up to you. You just want to have just some interesting shapes going on in here. Okay, let's do something else over here. And let's get this up out of the way. We'll come back to our brushes again and see what else we have. I'll take this and I'll double click on that. And again, new layer. And I'll put that right there to see what I've got. That's kind of fun. I'll just kind of bring that down here somewhere. Maybe I'll duplicate that layer and offset that and rotate that a little bit. Just giving us some complexity in there. And you can go ahead and just, you know, do more of this kind of stuff if you want to. Let me just merge these two together into one layer. So right click and I'll merge those layers. There we are. I just want this to be a little bit of just some stuff down here at the bottom. So I'm going to pull it way down like that. So just the tops for showing. Okay, so there's the whole idea on the shape. So you can see it's real easy to do. Simply new layers, so you can go back and recontrol those if you want to. You can always change them because they're on their own layers. If you put it all on one layer, then you're kind of stuck with it. If you have it on separate layers, you can show or hide parts. You can add more, take stuff away. So keep them on separate layers. It gives you more control. Let's now put that really cool lighting effect in here. And we'll do that with a layer up here and a gradient on this layer. There are two different ways of putting gradients. I will do one here. I'll do a different one for the text. So choose the new layer button. There we go. There's a new layer. And let's go to the gradient tool. Just click on the gradient and you see your different gradients up here. And I just happen to chose the default gradient and right there, just a rainbow gradient. And I'll grab my tool and I'm just going to come in here and just paint this gradient straight across like that. Nothing too dramatic about that, just a straight across gradient. Now the trick here is you want to come to our blending modes, come down here, right down towards the bottom where it says color, click on that and that blends in the color. And there you go, there's that real cool coloration of those layers. You can control how bright this is by adjusting the brightness. You know, further down, less color, further up, more color. So you have that control. You also can control the brightness of your different layers. Let me just unlock these things. Let's look at our one right there. That's layer 3. So I can bring layer 3 back a little bit in color or in brightness and give me some variation in here. So it has some color variation happening as well, or brightness variation. Again, another reason to have these on separate layers. Now let's put in our big bright highlights. And that's real fun, easy to do. Again, new layer. Go back to our brushes and we'll leave that on white. That's good. I want to go back to my default brushes now. Default brushes and just choose a soft brush and I'll bring the size up. And just kind of click where these things overlap. Like that. Now, if it's a big overlap, I can click a few times and get a brighter dot. If it's a smaller overlap, just a little small click. You can even make your sizes here, you know, larger or smaller to adjust the amount of brightness you get when you click. So I just brought that down a little bit and I'll do a few small ones in here. And a little one right there. I'm just hitting where the overlaps are happening. I'm not going to be hitting them all, but just a few of the overlaps. And there it is. There's our really interesting background happening. Now let's do our text, and on the text we'll have it a different color range. And that's easy to do. Let's just leave the color on white. grab the type tool right here, and let's just find an interesting type. So I'm going to scroll clear to the top. There we go. I want to have something that's pretty basic, nothing too dramatic. And we'll just scroll down and see what we have available in here. Now there are lots of free fonts available online as well. This just happens to be what I happen to have on my computer right now. I think I kind of like that one, Bauhaus 93. It's a real standard one. I like that one a lot. This one's good too, Berlin Sans. That's really good. Just, you know, lots of nice little basic typefaces in here. Let's just see what else. I just recently used those two, so I'll try to find something else a little bit different here. That looks good. Century Gothic, real standard typeface. Let's just grab that one. Click right here. Now my type size is a bit too large. I'm going to bring the type size down here. Bring it down to 24 point. I'll type in light, just like that. It's maybe a bit too small now that I can see what the size looks like. 48, pretty good. And now I can grab the control handles in here and adjust the size of that. Let me try that with uppercase instead of lowercase. There we go. Looks pretty good. So now I want to give this a different coloration than that one. If I put this underneath, you'll see what happens. If I pull this down underneath, it's going to get some of the lighting. See kind of the edges in there? It's lit by that. You get those little edges happening. But I want to do something different on this. So we're going to come in and give this its own coloration. I also want to have some softness in here on the edges. Now, so here's our light. Let's now do a new layer. I'm going to be doing an adjustment layer in here. Actually, a fill layer. Fill layer gradient. And we're going to use the previous layer to create a clipping mask. This is the previous layer, light. I'll use that as a clipping mask. And this is going to lock this gradient into that layer. Choose OK. Let's grab a gradient. Now this time I'm going to choose something a bit different. Let's come down here and take a look at our noise samples. And maybe something... yeah, that'll work. Choose OK. Now you can adjust the gradient down here. There we go, and just kind of move that around. Notice how this is a different gradient from that gradient because we're using a different setup. If I move this light here, let me just lock my gradient layer. There we go. If we move this on top, you can see how the gradients are staying separate. I'm not having an overlap on those gradients. Okay, we'll do just a little something else on this, make it a little more interesting. Go up here to our layer and layer style settings. I'm going to give it a slight glow here. I'm going to outer glow. Let's see, just a little bit, just kind of soften that up, just like that. And we'll give it a slight bevel as well. Just a little beveling on that edge. So you can see that, there it is, and okay. So there you go, here's how to do a real fancy looking kind of light streaky background thing. Real easy, and also how to apply gradients into letters as well and keep everything separate. So real fun, rather quick, and again, as you can see, the whole thing really depends upon getting some of those custom brushes, and again, you'll find the link for the custom brushes in the description. Thank you for watching this special Photoshop photography project video. Don't forget to subscribe so that you will get first notice of new project videos in the future. Just click on this link right here where it says subscribe here. You can get all 12 project videos in this series along with 26 special videos demonstrating the tools and techniques that I used in these projects by clicking on this link right down here. And then thank you again for watching this training video.